I finally reached 100 subscribers on my YouTube channel.
획기적 우위를 가지는 역사적 사변입니다. 국내 우주 강국 건설부상을 높이 받들어 높은 실력과 결사의 투쟁으로.
I would like to thank everyone for it because it wouldn't be possible without my viewers watching my YouTube video and subscribing to my channel and supporting the channel with all my nonsensical videos. I mean, there are some good videos inside, but hopefully all are good lah. So what do I think about my motovlogging so far? I could use a bit more practice when I'm talking because I tend to do a lot of pause, and actually pause is fine, it's just me, I tend to use a lot of wrong words and I tend to speak gibberish and everything comes out a mess. But yeah, I reached 100 subscribers thanks to you guys, and I promise to, you know, make more awesome videos if I can, because seriously, motovlogging in Singapore, it's really hard to come up with topic since I'm only riding for like less than half a year, and like only so much experience riding a bike, so I couldn't talk about bigger CC bikes and stuff because of the regulations in my country, and I'm only allowed to ride a small bike now. Maybe next year I'll be riding a bigger bike, but for now this bike is fine for me. So riding while motor vlogging is something you don't do naturally, obviously, because I don't know, when you try to talk and ride a motorcycle at the same time, sometimes you don't get to enjoy the small little things in riding itself. I don't know what I'm missing out when I do a motor vlog while I ride. It's just that I feel like I'm not really enjoying the whole process of riding because of the amount of thought I put into, you know, thinking of what I need to say and stuff. I mean, if I am just plain riding without talking, it's far more enjoyable than to talk. But you know, motovlogging is something I like to do, and I will continue doing them even though I feel like I don't really enjoy that much compared to just plain riding. But that might be due to the fact that there are so much cars around here, and you have to kind of like do so many things at one time when you motovlog, and you know, when you motovlog and kind of talk, I need to concentrate on the road at the same time. There are so many things I need to watch out for. That's why maybe it's not that enjoyable motovlogging in a country like Singapore, because of the amount of traffic you get. There's a growth in a motovlogging community in Singapore, I think, because of the amount of motovloggers popping up. And I would like to say that even though we might not get the amount of exposure compared to overseas motovlogger, but it's really a joy to be in the motovlogging scene, because the amount of motorcycle riders you meet due to motovlogging for me has been tremendous. I've got to know like Heiko, Miku Gonyu, Skid Mark, and many more through motovlogging itself, and you know, Red Dot as well, through motovlogging. Just motovlogging, I get to know all these riders and you know, make friends with them. We even have our own chat group. So I have to say that I've been enjoying my motovlogging hobby a lot, and for anyone riding feel free to join the MotorVlogging community. You know when the views, when the view counts start to jump in your video, you start to feel like, wow, shook man, because people are actually watching the stuff you put online, and it's a very nice feeling to have. It's not even about money, I'm not monetizing any shit. Even if I do, I don't get any shit because of the amount of views I get. It's too little to, you know, get monetized or cash in the amount of money I earn. It's just really for pure love for riding that I'm motovlogging. But sure, motovlogging and editing the video do take up time in your personal life. That no doubt, because editing the video is tough, man. It's not that easy editing the videos. At first I thought it was easy, but really editing videos is not that easy. Sometimes you feel like you are talking too much. Sometimes you don't even know what you're talking. And sometimes it's just plain nonsense. And you start to contemplate whether you should upload all this nonsense or not. But overall, the motovlogging journey has been fun, and it's a nice learning process for me as well, because I've never edited any video in my life until I started motovlogging. So it's really a learning journey for me, and something I really enjoy doing despite the amount of time it takes to edit one single video. So anyway, I'd like to thank you guys, the subscribers and just the normal regular viewers of my video, for making it happen for me, for getting my 100 subscribers, and that's all I have for today. So peace out.